Hi, I'm Catherine McNulty, and I want to talk a little bit today about the power of affirmations and how I use them on my grief journey. So in order to do that, I really need to share a story with you. So as many of you know, I lost my infant son back in 2011, and I left the hospital a mother without a child. And I walked into my house and it was completely, there was just this empty feeling. Everything I had planned was gone. Everything I thought was gonna happen over the next day, months, weeks, it wasn't gonna happen anymore. And my head, like even today, my body feels very warm talking about it. I honestly just, I didn't know what I was gonna do. And I didn't know where to go. I was empty. I was so numb from the pain that was there, right? It was so much pain that I honestly couldn't feel anything. So I went to support groups, and the good thing about support groups, especially for me early on, was they got me to talk about my story. And so I shared what happened, and when I shared what happened, all of the pain that I had been numbing came out, which honestly is a good thing. I totally believe that you have to get the pain out. But there was a moment when I was sitting there and I could watch all of the other people who had also lost babies. And I could hear their stories. And so I was crying for me. I was crying for them because it was just, right? You think your story is devastating and then you hear somebody else's story that's even more devastating. And you just collectively grieve and you collectively cry. But there was a shift when I looked into their eyes and I saw their lack of hope and the desperation, and it made me ask myself, like, do I have any hope? Is there hope for me? And there was a point when I sat in my chair and I looked around the room and there were tears streaming down my face. And my head hurt just from the crying and the, but then something started to churn within me. And it started small at first, and over weeks it got stronger. But it was that sense of, this is not who I am. This is something that happened to me. But who I am is someone that doesn't let life destroy me. And so in that moment, that's when I decided I was gonna stand up. I was gonna figure this grief thing out. I was gonna do what it took to get through it. I had no idea how, but I knew, because I said in my heart, I am stronger than this. I am going to be okay. I am going to get through it, and I am going to figure it out. And so even today, when things are hard, whether it be in relation to the loss of my son or in the loss of, you know, in things that are going on in my life now, when things are really hard, I go back to the who am I. And I do a lot of work in terms of listening to other speakers, to other, I listen to a lot of Les Brown, I listen to Lisa Nichols, I listen to Brene Brown, all really good authors. And I go to them when I need a pick-me-up myself. And they all will remind me the power of affirmation, the power of I am, and what it means to look yourself in the mirror or to pull it from deep down when you're deepest in pain and say, who am I? And who do I want to be? And I can shift back to times when I was really strong and say, this is who I am. And for me, I am someone with courage. I am someone who's strong. I am someone who doesn't let life happen to me. This is my life. And I'm gonna figure this out, and it's likely not gonna be what I want it to be, what I expected it to be, but I'm gonna be okay. I'm gonna figure this out. And for me, I'm gonna share it with you in the hopes that a little bit of my journey, a little piece of my story will give you a little bit of hope into your own I am. So I ask you today, in your darkest hour, who are you? And can you say to yourself, I am?